Well, you've got no sex education in our house. You had to find it all out by yourself. I remember I was about 9. I walked out the buildings where I lived. I was with my father, and there were a couple of dogs locked together. So I said, Dad, I said, what are those dogs doing? He said, yeah, well... One of the back's got a bad leg, hasn't he? You see, one in front's giving him a piggyback to the hospital. I remember once I went to the swimming bars. I must have been about 13, 14. And I was drying myself off. I lifted my arm and suddenly I saw these hairs. And I thought, oh my God, my stuffing's coming out. And a few nights later, I was at the cinema and I was sitting with this girl. She was about a year older than me, you see, and something erotic happened on the screen because suddenly she turned my face to hers and she kissed me full on the lips. And then she pushed her tongue right into my mouth and started wiggling it about. And I didn't know it was supposed to excite me. I thought she was after my chewing gum. What a life, eh? Did you ever anybody come up to you and say to you, what is the most embarrassing moment of your life? We've all had one. Now, for me, it's got to be the day my mother took all us kids to Brighton for the day. Boiling hot day. We're all walking along the promenade, sucking ice cream cones. And she's got a blouse on, a satin blouse. And she doesn't know it, but it's open. And one bosom is completely naked. Nowadays, they wouldn't take a blind bit of notice. But in those days... A policeman came up alongside her. He said, oi, missus, oi, come on, come on. Bit of decency, bit of decency. And she looked, she said, oh, my God, I've left the baby on the bus.